Okay, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. You may be wondering who is next to me here. Next to me is brother Kem. Kem, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Brother Kem, he took shahada 3 months ago. When I heard his story, I was thinking, wow, alhamdulillah, such a wonderful story. So I want to document the story so you can also be motivated as much as I got motivated. When did you took your shahada, by the way?
I took my shahada 3 months ago in IFN Masjid.
Only 3 months ago. And how old are you?
I am 20 years old.
20 years young, right? MashaAllah. And what was, you know, I mean, nowadays, there are so many distractions for the youth, not just for the youth, all of us. So what made a 20-year-old look into religion, look into Islam of all the religions, right? Despite all the Islamophobia out there, and now chose to become a Muslim?
The important reason why I decided to become a Muslim is when I visited a masjid for the first time, the first thing that I noticed was the unity and how people put everyone else first and they put themselves last, how they care for their brother, for their sister. And yeah, I could say mainly it was the unity and also the knowledge within Islam.
MashaAllah, right? You know, many a times we are too harsh on ourselves, on the Muslims. They, you know, look at the Muslims, Islam is the best, look at the Muslims. Yes, that is true, by the way. But Muslim Ummah has wonderful attributes. They are the best of Ummah. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Surah number 3, ayah number 110. Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas, ta'muruna bil ma'rufi wa tanhawna anil munkar wa tu'minuna billah. So the translation is, addressing to the Muslim Ummah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that you are the best of Ummah created for humanity. So Allah is saying that Muslims, you are the best because you enjoin good, you forbid evil, and you believe in Allah. So despite all the deficiencies that we have, and may Allah make us better, still there are many, many fellow Americans, non-Muslims, they look into the Muslims, the Muslim Ummah, and they are converting to Islam, alhamdulillah. So Brother Kem, what message that you have for the other youth who are out there, who may be lost?
What I would recommend is resist temptation, resist. I know that it's difficult, the struggle, it's very difficult in occasion, especially at this age. But just by resisting, you're taking one step towards Allah. And Allah says, take one step towards me, and I would take 10 steps towards you. Walk towards me, and I would run towards you. And for me, when you think about it, the best reward you could ever receive is having Allah with you.
MashaAllah. Such words of wisdom, right? Alhamdulillah. Right now, you're not staying in your home. Are you?
No. So I was born in Puerto Rico, one of the U.S. territories, as a Jehovah's Witness. My family is a strict Jehovah's Witness, really prideful with their religion. When I converted, for them that was outrageous. It was crazy for them to have a Muslim son, especially at this time where Muslims are considered extremists, terrorists, oppressors. For them it was not a good thing, so they decided to expel me from my house. And now I am living with a Palestinian Bosnian host family. They took me in and they have made me feel like a son. And alhamdulillah, I am here now.
You know, can you imagine the only child in the family and he is a Muslim? And the parents kick a person out, and still with a smile, he's saying, you know what? Alhamdulillah. This is how the aqidah, the content a person should have, despite all the challenges. We should say, alhamdulillah. There's always a higher, bigger purpose that Allah has for you, right? So, but you know, there is a really important aspect about your life that reminded me about one of the famous Sahabi, one of the famous companions of Muhammad, peace be upon him. His name was Musa bin Umair. He went through something similar, by the way. He was one of the richest youth in all of Makkah. After he heard that the Prophet is a true Prophet, there is one creator, Islam is a true faith, this person, he converted to Islam. Have you heard his story, by the way?
Yeah, I have heard his story. I've been told a couple of times about my stories being similar to his.
Yes, so after Musa bin Umair, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, after he told his parents, or they found out that he became a Muslim, they literally kicked him out. They kicked him out. He propagated the message to such an extent that the Prophet himself trained him and he sent him to Medina. He propagated the message, and even before the Prophet came to Medina, almost every house has at least one person who was a Muslim. So Brother Kim, what message that you have for the non-Muslims out there? You know, they are watching all of the Fox News, the Islamophobia out there, all the misconceptions, and they're not looking into Islam, right? So what message that you have for them about why they should look into Islam?
My recommendation and my message to all the non-Muslim is to not listen to what social media says. Don't listen to what you see on a daily basis on social media. The angel told the Prophet, Iqra, read. The only recommendation and the best one I'm going to tell you is to read. Acquire knowledge and go to different scholars. Ask questions. Don't leave with a question. Ask always a question. Read the Quran and try to always maintain an open image that there's going to be a bad side, how people put it, but it's not always what people say. When you're part of the community, that's when you realize that the whole time people were wrong.
Alhamdulillah, right? Wonderful advice. So any non-Muslim who's listening up there, do not take your Islam from some misguided Muslims, from the Fox News, from the Islamophobes. If you have to know what Islam is, pick up a copy of the Quran, a translation, and look into the noble life of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And you will find out that Islam stands for peace and justice. Islam stands for unity and morality. And that would be the best decision that you would make, inshallah. With that, again, congratulations. Welcome to Islam, my dear brother. Alhamdulillah.